Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Xmarie here. So this looks very different, I know, to the normal video that I would do. Normally I'm sat in front of a computer. However, a few weeks ago, one of my games, I did mention to you guys on the video that I wanted to start bringing some other thing into my YouTube videos. Now, as you know, if you are obviously subscribed to me, you'll know that my channel at the moment is just basically gaming. I do a lot of horror-related indie games on there, which I'm enjoying a lot. But the thing is, I wanted to bring something else onto my channel as well, other than just gaming. And it's something that I have wanted to do for a very, very, very long time, and I've only really just felt like I've had the chance to actually do it, and that is SFX. So, an age of when I started to watch horror movies and things like that, a lot of the things when I was watching them, what I was interested in is how they did the SFX. So like, if there were like aliens in it, or if there were like cuts and bruises and, you know, horror scenes and things, my brain was always in, how have they done that? That's amazing. Like, how have they created something like this? And so I used to watch all the behind the scenes shows to basically look how it was done, and it always fascinated me. And I've never really just had faith in myself to just try it. At the end of the day, you don't know what you're good at until you've actually tried it for yourself and you've done it. I could be completely terrible at this, but at least then I can say that I have tried it. So this is me self-teaching SFX makeup, doing horror things. So if you are a follower of mine on Instagram or on TikTok, you probably already know this, as I have tested out on there a couple of my SFX looks already. So I just wanted to kind of start uploading videos on how I created things. And obviously, like I said, I'm self-teaching, so I'm watching other people's videos on how things are done. Bought myself a very large SFX starter kit to basically get everything together that I feel that I'll need to start doing this properly. I invested in quite a lot of products. I've got so many boxes here. Like, this is just my normal makeup box that I use in the morning. But then also I have a SFX box here that's full of like crafts and stuff and things to make, like my SFX. I've got liquid latex upstairs at the side of my bed. I've got my brushes here, I've got some more stuff there. This is another thing, like with like fake blood in and 99% alcohol, and there's so many things. There's some of this stuff I still don't even know how to use. And obviously the last week I haven't uploaded anything on my YouTube channel, and I am sorry for that. I do like to try and upload as often as possible. This week has been quite difficult because what's happened is I've bought myself a new camera, which is what you are seeing me on now. And with cameras, there can be quite a lot of teething issues to see on like how to use it. Is it going out of focus when I'm using it? Like, and I filmed a few of the things, but it didn't film right. And when I watched the footage back, things were just like really blurred all the way through, and it was just unwatchable. I couldn't put it up for you guys, so I'm really sorry about that. That's why it's taking me so long to do anything. There's a lot in SFX, there's a lot of stuff to learn. If you see me doing anything that you think that's not right, you shouldn't really be doing that, let me know down in the comments, because I'd really appreciate, obviously, if there is anything that I'm doing wrong, that's how you learn from things, by people saying that you've done something wrong. And then you can think, right, okay, what's the right way of doing it? Let me change that. It's not going to be the most amazing SFX you've ever seen in your life, but I think most of it is just you guys following my YouTube journey on how to learn SFX, to see if the more I do it, the better it gets. So I'm really, really excited to show you this and to start doing videos. I have a few looks planned out, so if you've seen my TikTok or even my Instagram as well, you will have already seen that I have already done a Pirates of the Caribbean inspired look, also she's like a hell bitch. She's a lady from hell, let's just say that, with the horns and stuff. I did her, quite liked that one a lot. And then I've also done this prosthetic skull as well, which I created out of tissue, cotton wool and latex. I'm trying to make things, like, not buy prosthetics, I'm trying to make them myself. And they are quite difficult to create, I'm not gonna lie. They can be quite hard and they take a long time to dry. So today, I have a look for you guys that someone actually advised in my comments on Instagram that I should do, like sometimes I ask questions on Instagram and stuff to try and find out what kind of looks that people would like to see, and somebody said, why don't you do the nurse from Silent Hill? So I was like, okay then. I love Silent Hill, okay? The Silent Hill games are amazing. I loved the Silent Hill films. I think there's two, is there two? I'm pretty sure there's two. But I just love everything about them. They're just, I don't know what it is about them. They're just creepy as hell, but they're amazing. I love them. I can never watch them enough. So the Silent Hill nurses were always something that I think creeps most people out. That scene when they're all stood together and she's trying to sneak past them, she has to turn a light off because the nurses see her and they're gonna be like, I'm gonna jab you, and she's trying to get past them and then they start cutting each other and stuff. That scene was like, whoa, okay. So I wanted to do that a lot. So today I'm going to show you how I created this look for the nurse. Obviously at this point I don't actually know how it's going to turn out, but I hope for you guys and for myself that it turned out well, so I hope you enjoy. Okay guys, so this is me starting to make the face cast. As you can see here, we have the strips to put on our face, some scissors and a bowl of water as well. So you want to take that makeup off. Now I look like a naked mole rat, you're welcome. Start cutting the cast into strips, and don't forget as well to apply Vaseline to your eyebrows and any baby hairs as well. This will just make sure that the cast does not pull those hairs out when it comes off. So start wetting those strips and applying them to your face. It's best to use warm water with this. They apply a lot more easier when you do so. Okay, so do this until your entire face is covered, but don't forget to leave your nostrils out. You don't want to be covering those up, and also your eyes as well. You can do around your eyes, just don't stick anything over your eyes because it will not be very nice and you cannot see. Pull the face cast off when it's dry. It should be dry in a few minutes. And now what we're doing once the face cast is dry is laying on extra bandages. This will just create the bandaged look of the nurse's face. So do this however you want, however you feel is the best way for you to do it. I'm just laying these strips diagonally. I'm gonna go over both eyes, but make sure at this point as well that you do leave a gap for you to be able to see, and also a slight gap where your nostrils are as well, so you can breathe. When wearing this mask, it was still quite it was still fairly difficult to breathe through, but I could breathe, so it did leave enough. But just make sure you do that, otherwise it'll be very difficult for you to wear this mask. Okay, I'm just putting a bit of a gooey bit as well over the other eye. And here we go, we're gonna start painting. So for this, I am using the Mehron palettes. These both came in a set together. And I'm starting with the color Light Olive to just put a light base all over the cast. This is just to give it a kind of just a dirty bandaged look. So we're just gonna put that everywhere. Do is as well is start adding a darker brown just to give those bandages a bit more of a dirty look, and also just to add depth. Remember that darker colors add depth, lighter colors highlight, so you're going to need both of those with this mask. So we're just going to dab that over as well, just to kind of make it all merge together and look a bit nicer. Okay, so now we're going to start painting the gross nasty bit on the eye. We're just going to go in that with the red here that we have. I think that's called Bloody Rose that I'm using, and also a little bit of burnt maroon as well for the color wheel. Okay, so the look is almost completed. You just want to make sure we get in all of those little cracks there and crevices so you can't see any more of the face cast. Just finishing off any little edges that need tidying up there. Once it's dry, you might need to touch it up a little bit as well.
that is your finished face cast. Just add a couple of highlights there with some white, not too much, but just to make it stand out a bit more. And that's your finished project.
Okay guys, so now we have the mask made that you can see here. Now unfortunately with this mask, I do only have one type of paint at the moment. Really, I think that probably most people, as it stands, need probably three types of paints. This was done using cream paints, but I do need to get some water activated paints and some alcohol activated paints as well. I just think it would cover better. It was really difficult to cover this. I was probably having to jab in it because obviously with this kind of cast stuff, it's very like lumpy and bumpy. So I was trying to like really dig down to get in all the holes and stuff. So it was really difficult, but we got it covered. So I'm hoping. So let's take a look through. So I'm gonna hold this on with bandages because obviously the silent home nurses have a lot of bandages wrapped around their heads. You're not really gonna see any of my actual face, but what I am gonna do is just paint around my eyes with black just to make sure you cannot see them, because this light is pretty bright and it might pick up the fact that my eyes are not black around them. So where is my goddamn brush? I have lots of brushes in here. So many brushes. I need more though, obviously. So I'm using again the Mehron kit that I have here. I made a mess of this, so yeah. So I'm really gonna hate me for this mess, but you know, it is what it is. I'm just gonna go straight in with this and I'm just gonna paint around my eyes. This Mehron is the same palette as you can see. I use the whole tin. Just for this mask. This is why grease paints are not good for that kind of thing. I definitely need water-based paint. So I'm just gonna go over my eyes. I'm just gonna go over the makeup that I've already got because it's just not gonna mean anything else anyway. It doesn't matter. And I cannot be able to take it off. You've already seen me once already with no makeup. You don't want to be scared again. I don't know what that accent was, guys. I just did it. Okay, I'm sorry. Let's escape home to a place where dreams are doors you can. This is the new fashion, okay? Sexy. Yeah, work it. It's just the messy look. All the trends now, guys. All the trends. Rub it down a little bit. La la. Na na na. Du du du. Du du. I think that's just fine and dandy. Okay, so we gotta get this on my face, okay? So I have some bandages here. I'm not gonna need any wigs today. Not gonna need to do anything with this piece of crap, what I call hair. We're just gonna need the bandages and also possibly some tape, but we might need this, we may not. We'll see how it goes when it wraps. I also have as well a little nursey blah blah little cap there. This was literally just made out of fabric, so it just flops down all the time, so I literally just stuck some cotton there with some glue to make it stand up. That's it guys, that is all that is to it. It might look terrible, I'm sorry if it does. It is what it is.
No.
For this part I'm going to use a wig cap because my hair is super thick. I need it down. Right, let's get this on, baby. Stretch it out a little bit. These things are not the most stretchiest in the world. I obviously must have a big head because, you know, I just took my hair up in the back of that, like that, like you would with any wig, my friend. Okay. around my head. I want to keep it quite straight. But don't forget, if you are following a look like this, don't forget the ears, because those nurses, as far as I know, do not have no ears. Gonna wrap that around. They're actually not gonna see the back of my head anyways, which is fine, because you don't want to see the back of my head. Why would you? Okay, so this time we're going to use the second piece of bandage to cover that over everything. I can't open my hair grip because I've got my... Oh, no! How? I can't... I can't open it with my finger. Ew. I can't see my grips properly. Like, I can't see shit right now. Not the most secure, and if it comes with my face, I'm very upset because it'll probably smash on the floor, which is, yeah, it's not holding. Okay, that feels a little more secure. I think it's difficult to know, but hey ho. Oh my god, I can't say shit. I'm gonna use. There's not barely any of that bit left, so I'm going to use a bit of this one. I'm just going to paint over these damn bandages to try and make them look real dirty. I've got an itchy nose, it's a problem, it's a real problem. Okay, so now I've done that, I think I'm going to, where the hell is my sponge? I don't know, bitch. I don't know. Oh, this could work, okay. No, that's not working. Okay, great. That's not giving me the vibes I need. Okay, so now I need to dirty this up because this is way too white. The silent hill nurses, just saying. You see those bitches, they don't have white. They are filthy. Is never going to be finished without scab, like without some kind of blood. So I'm going to use squirt blood, and I'm just going to little bit in my dish here. There we go. We only need a tiny drop of that because this stuff kind of goes along the way. Just want to kind of dab it on there and make it look narrowly. I think that blood in SFX is just always the way forward. It always looks good. It always makes things look better. It will never not make things look better. So you always need the blood. We just want it like kind of splat around there. I'm gonna get any on my clothes. Not these clothes anyways. On the bandage a little bit. We want the kind of like a gross, nasty looking vibe up there too. We want it kind of splat all over here. Should we just dab it in my eye on this side? I can see slightly through gaps, so that's how I'm managing this right now. Although it is difficult, it's not the easiest. Kind of bring it over the nose a little bit there. Dab it on here as well, make it look all gross and gangly. I think we'll probably have just a little bit more on there just to make it look extra spicy. Even up there, because surely if like these nurses are freaking violent, so you know if they've been cutting people up, they'd certainly have some up there on there, without a doubt, my friend, without a doubt. Okay, cool with the cucumber. Maybe, just a maybe, guys, we might use a little bit of the Mehron coagulate blood as well. That might just make it look a little bit more in depth. Squirt blood is very kind of squirty, as you would imagine. Coagulated is as you would think, it's coagulated. It just looks like it's kind of thick, gloopy blood that's come from like really deep or something. So we just want to kind of add some of that here and there. Give it a little bit of dip. This is just really good. It does go a long way as well. Even though I only have a small pot, it seems to spread really nicely. So good stuff. Okay, I think I'm ready for the costume. Okay, let's go. Okay, so we're back. This is just a nurse's outfit that I had a while ago, and I thought would be good to use for this. I was like, oh my god, I have a nurse's outfit. This is perfect. So, yes. So, let's just dirty myself up a bit. This is just, I'm just not dirty enough, you know? So, we need to get some dirt and mud, because obviously those nurses are not clean, guys. You know, you've seen this. I'm gonna use some of this brown. Put some in the cleavage. Sorry about this, guys. Around the neck, we really want to smudge it out, because we don't want it to be like, I have got fake tan on right now, so this is just gonna look the same as that. I just want to kind of drag it down my arms. I'm going to put some on my clothes as well. I sound out of breath because it's just hard to breathe in this, like, it really is. Just want it everywhere. Like I said, it already kind of looked dirty with the feet down anyway. Whoops! Get those hands dirty. Okay. Maybe even put like a bit of grey in there, because obviously they're supposed to be dead. They're not living things, they're not real. Well, they are real, but they're not like real real, so it's quite easy to make yourself look dead if you put a lot of grey in there. So I'm gonna do that. SFX is a lot about making yourself look really gross and disgusting, so this is the kind of stuff that you can't be afraid of. I'm gonna also make my outfit really like filthy as well. Obviously I would not have a nice bright white clean outfit if I was a dead nurse from Silent Hill, so. Okay, so I think we should put some blood on our outfit as well, on our person. We use a stickle sponge again for this. Just kind of makes it look like it's all splattered. Do I have blood on me somewhere? You've got red on you. So, I think, wherever my paintbrush has gone, I cannot find it because I cannot see. I cannot see. Just put a little bit more there. I feel like that was just kind of lacking some of the dirtiness that we need right now. Okay guys, so that is the finished look. So if you have any other ideas, any other horror movies, if you've seen something before in a horror movie and you're like, oh my god, I wish someone would recreate that, let me know down in the comments. And obviously, you can also contact me on Instagram as well. But thank you so, so much for watching this today. I really appreciate you watching it, with it being the first SFX video that I've done. It means a lot to me. So thank you so, so much, and I'll see you guys in the next video.